So to our last final of the day, it's mixed doubles. It's the world and Olympic champions Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei from China up against the defending All England champions Tantowi Akman and Liliana Natsir of Indonesia. So let's go down courtside now to Howard Bentham and get the players into the arena.
Please welcome the players in the mixed doubles final from China, the number 5 seeds, Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei.
The former All England champions, the current world champions, the current Olympic champions. Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei of China. So both these pairs appearing in their second All England final. Indonesians, of course, second consecutive. Whereas the Northern Olympic champions, Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei, winners of this title in 2010 when they came through the qualifying rounds to eventually lift the trophy. So last year's champions, Tantowi Akman, the 25-year-old from Banyumas in the southwest of Central Java. Liliana Natsir playing in her fourth All England final, the 27-year-old from Manado in the north of North Sulawesi. Their win-loss record for the year prior to this All England was a quarter final at the Korean Super Series. But the world number twos have had a super tournament here in Birmingham. Tough old match in their quarter-final against the European champions Robert Matusiak and Nadia Ziba from Poland. And what a thriller it was in the semi-final against a brother and sister pair of Marcus Kido and Pierre Bernadette. It really was an absolute thriller, 21-19 in the deciding game. So they've been stretched all the way in their last two matches. So to the Chinese combination, Zhang Nang turned 23 just 9 days ago. Zhao Yunlei 26, and as you can see, their world ranking at 5. They have been world number ones. 82 weeks they spent as world number ones, and as I was saying, won this event in 2010 as qualifiers. Only tournament played so far this year was the Korean Super Series. They won that, but they had to battle extremely hard in their quarter final, which was against Fan Kuniawan and Sheni Puspa Irawati of Indonesia. Now, of course, only one seeded pair that they've had to play on their way through to today's final, and that was their semi-final. Number seven seeds, Mohamed Rejal and Debbie Susanto. Both these pairs appearing in their second All-England final, obviously for the Indonesians as defending champions, second consecutive final. This the seventh meeting between these two pairs, and as you can see, the reigning world and Olympic champions, Jang Nan and Jiaoyin Lei, have the advantage, having won four of their previous six encounters. But perhaps most significant was the last meeting. It was the Indonesians that won, beating the Chinese pair in the semi-final of the Denmark Open last year.
This is the Yonex All England Open Badminton Championships mixed doubles final between, on my right, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yuli, China. And on my left, Tontowi Ahmad and Lidiana Natsir, Indonesia. Lidiana Natsir to serve to Zhang Nan. Lawol play.
So Lidiana Natsir appearing in her fourth All England final. Getting these mixed doubles underway. Former partner with whom she was beaten twice in this All England final, Nova Widianto, sitting on the coach's bench.
One love.
Well, I thought that Jiaoyin Lei was looking a little bit sluggish in her women's doubles final. No doubt that the coaches have had her on the practice court, making sure she's a little sharper from the start of this mixed doubles. Yeah, she certainly is. Well, for the Chinese pair, their Indonesian opponents are the fourth consecutive Indonesian pair they've played in this year's tournament. Well, the Indonesians trying to become the first pair to retain a mixed doubles title since the Chinese combination of Jingbo and Gao Ling in 2007 and 2008. Now, Anthony, obviously we've watched mixed doubles all week and you've talked extensively about how important the woman's role is in mixed doubles, how she's got to control the front of the court. Do you see this final as a clear battle between the two women as to who's going to really dominate the match?
Absolutely. The ladies in mixed doubles, they're like the playmakers. They're the ones at the front in the firing line. And a real contrast in styles between the two women. Lidiana Natsir, very, very skillful, likes to play a lot of net shots. Doesn't generally be as aggressive as her opponent, Jiaoyin Lei. She likes to come flying forwards, always looking to kill the shuttle. So it's a great contrast, and be interesting to see who comes out on top of that battle, because whoever's on the attack is going to be the winner.
To be a bit of a showboater on court. I mean, he's really focused and really concentrated. He's obviously a world-class player. No service fault called. Struck above the waist, says service judge Giappini from Italy. was a super return too, wasn't it, from Liliana Natsia. There's Nova Warrington on the left. Liliana Natsia's former partner. Yeah. World titles together, 2005 and 2007. Short. Goodness! Well, Indonesians haven't even hit three more shots than I think they probably expected.
Although Zhao Yunlei mishit the very first smash, it does possess an incredible defence. You know, all the four players do defend very, very well, but when the shuttle is as short as it was, chances of getting three, four, five back, very, very difficult. That's a very clever smash from Ackman. You know, we're used to seeing the men trying to go hard towards the ladies. He's caught Zhang Nan off guard.
Matured in the last two or three years since he's been playing with Liliana Natsir. When I first saw him play, I thought he was tactically very naive, but he's improved considerably. He thinks more about his placement now.
He was always very, very fast when I first saw him come onto the tour. I did think, not sure quite why they've put these two together, knowing how good Nova Widianto was in the past. But like you say, the more and more he's played and learned from Liliana Natsir, he's using stop drops, angle slices, and then combining it with the big power as well.
And that was a run of six straight points. Levels is appearing in her sixth All-England final. Fifth was the first final of the day.
See Zhao Yunlei missing those. That was, I mean, you couldn't get an easier put away. It's just lack of concentration for that split second.
A shot between the legs. That's a super move. Sliced across the feathers of the shuttle. And that creates extra spin. And the extra spin brings the shuttle down a lot quicker, creating the angle. Oh, it is absolutely fabulous. So to the mid-game interval, with a 5-point advantage. China has been experimenting with the mixed doubles partnerships. Chen Nan and Zhao Yunlei haven't been playing regularly together. They've tried out Zhang Nan with Tang Xinhua. Zhao Yunlei has played a couple of tournaments with the winner of the men's doubles, Xu Xihan. And I just wonder, Anthony, if that's changing of partnerships and a little bit of experimenting. I can understand why the coach would do that, because sometimes partnerships get a little bit stale, and therefore just to have a couple of tournaments with somebody else brings back the sparkle again. But I wonder in a way if it's disturbed the rhythm and the understanding between Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei.
It could definitely do so. I mean, you know, the coaches will decide who is going to play the tournaments with who. I think sometimes a good idea, it gives the younger players, the inexperienced players, a chance to play with a great partner like both of these two. Like I say, if they're not playing those tournaments week in, week out with one another, there can be that timing issue, understanding of who's taking what shot to play and what to look for, because every different player has a different way of hitting certain shots.
Of course, you've got to also add into the dynamic the fact that Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei are very close off-court as well. So if the on-court partnership has been sort of tampered with, then, you know, all these issues come into how you feel when you're back into the major tournament, the All England, and you expect it to produce your best.
Starting to see Zhang Nan getting his feet moving a lot more now. He thought out of the four players, he was the one that was slowest out of the blocks. He was static on defence. He was just lifting the shuttles away a lot more. Now, after the turn, it looks like he's got his A game out. Anticipation at the net from Nasir. Leading the game so well. That's the understanding in mixed doubles. If you know where your partner's going to smash, you can look for the percentage reply.
As you were saying, she doesn't look as spectacular as her opponent, but my goodness, she has that reading and understanding of the game and where to place the shuttle.
It's almost like she can hold the shuttle on the strings to wait for an opponent to move and then very quickly flick it down. Just going on Zhao Yunlei, he's varying it to both players so that she can't settle, and eventually he's finding the hip, the right hip of Zhao Yunlei, and she isn't reading those at all.
this is, I'm sure, going to make Indonesian fans a little bit nervous, because the number of times I've seen Tantowi Ahmad in good winning positions and then tries to be a little fancy with some of his play and loses his concentration, but it was good to see him in that rally. It was a wonderful kill. Made it look easy, but I can assure you it wasn't. Look, his shuttle's gone past him. Control the racket head there was very, very good.
Chinese need to make a bit of an statement of intent to attack a lot more. They're just giving the attack to the Indonesians too easily. You know, this pair, when they're on the attack and Ahmad's moving around as quickly as he is, they're just too good in that area.
Good judgment there too. Number two seeds, 2 points away from this opening game. That's nice.
To have come forwards just to cover the front of the court. Again, his feet are static.
Game point opportunities. That's a miss hit from Jannat. And the defending champions close out the opening game in comfortable style. 21-30.
Too many good points all day at the finals. Who's here supporting China? It's our new leader, China!
All credit to the Indonesians, because I have to say, they were very sharp. They were playing the game they wanted to play. And their awards, it was a comfortable opening game. 21-13 in 15 minutes. After their coaches left them, still deep in conversation about what they should be trying to do to turn this match around. In all honesty, I thought that Tantowi Ahmad and Liliana Natsir were just so impressive in that opening game. Anthony, you were saying that the Chinese pair had got to stop allowing the Indonesians to attack. How do you do that? Easier said than done, of course, but tactically, what have you got to try and do?
Well, we all know that Zhang Nan is quite a casual player. He likes to stroke the shuttles around, but he needs to be more aggressive, step forward that little bit and use the net more. If you're going to allow your partner to be aggressive on the net, you've got to play it to the net. You know, every point we're seeing him lift away. Zion Lake, the most aggressive killer of the shuttle in the game, and she's barely been at the net. Rally, Yang Nan clearly getting a hit of the shuttle. There's the attacking play on Jeremy May once again. I wonder if the Indonesian coaches, I'm sure they probably were down here for the first final of the day, possibly watching Zhao Yunlei. It was quite obvious that she was not at her best form in the women's doubles. Decided to pressurize her.
It's definitely a good advice, isn't it? Take advantage of the weaker player. You know, if we're talking that way at the Olympics last year, that would have been absurd. But like I say earlier, in the ladies' doubles, she was poor. And so far, they are playing her all around the court.
Beatable in the Olympics last year. It's not strictly true, is it? Because, of course, Zhao Yunlei and Tian Qing lost one of their group matches in the women's doubles. But, of course, she ended up winning both the women's doubles gold and the mixed doubles gold. First badminton player ever to win two golds in the same Olympic Games.
Serve over. Two off.
To lift. Just used to seeing that from Zhao Yunlei. She wasn't really ready. She just poked her up top foot. Normally used to seeing her just taking them off the top of the tape.
Foot!
Lower service, foul called. Getting very frustrated. And I think the service judge indicated that the racket wasn't pointing in a downward direction. Can't do it, is it? Ability, or is that something you coach to make people understand and read the game like that?
There's a certain element that you can coach into a player to understand what shots are possible from a certain situation. But, you know, certain great players just have that ability to just be able to read a situation much, much better than anybody else.
Of that in all three doubles disciplines, and that was exemplified quite beautifully in that line.
It's almost like a set play, isn't it? The return of serve from Natsir, nicely played down the tram line. Ahmed knows that the reply has to come straight, so he pushes right up the court and hits the open gap.
Given a bonus of $2 million, but oh dear, which is just under $22,000. And I understand that their national federation has just introduced 2 months ago and said that they were going to have the most valuable player of the year each year, and they were going to get 1 billion rupiah in bonus. So that's over $100,000. Quite frankly, the way they're playing at the moment, the Indonesians, they look very valuable indeed.
They do. Everything that they do at the moment is absolute perfection. And Ahmed's finding the lines on angles, he's varying the attack, playing a very, very clever game of mixed doubles. The game so well, Liliana Natsir. Yes, she missed on this occasion. She just knows exactly what the Chinese are going to do on every occasion.
To the net, Jeremy Lake.
certainly not surprised the umpire is having a little word with Zhao Yunlei. Aggressive gesture after winning the rally. Girish Natu of India on the umpire. Certainly, the way the Indonesians have played this final, they've been in absolutely great form, and it is lovely to see, isn't it, Anthony? Because I felt very much that after the Olympic Games, when they lost that bronze medal playoff match, so ended up fourth, the most desperate position for any athlete to finish in an Olympic Games, and I felt they had a real psychological slump, which obviously affected their game and their results, but they're back playing to their very best.
They are in this tournament, couldn't agree more. Like you say, I was at the Olympics and I saw the devastation on their faces when they lost the semi-final, to know they weren't going to be able to play for the gold, and in the third quarter playoff, almost uninterested in the position they were going to finish in, but massive psychological effect after that tournament.
Yeah, I think in a way that's a bit harsh, because I think they were desperately trying but just had no ability to lift themselves out of the emotional quagmire that they were in after losing that semi-final against Zhuchen and Ma Jin, because they've been in a winning position. And that, I think, is something they've got to be careful of right now, because I see the Indonesians in a winning position. They've played great so far, but they mustn't take their foot off the pedal if they want to retain their title. Most of the time you'd say that's the same tactic, wouldn't you, to get the lady to the back of the court, pressurise her at the back. She can't hit through you from the back of the court, and that gives you options to work your opponents before then switching the defensive play into attack yourselves.
Of course, a great tactic to get such a great net player like Lin-Yan Natsir away from that area. Being a bit naive for me, the Chinese, because they keep going through Ahmed at the net or in front of him at the net, and he's so competent in those areas. You know, I almost want to see a cross block into the open gap to then get the attack back.
Partner, she's very much the commander. But having had a 6-point advantage at one stage, now just a 2-point cushion as far as the Indonesians are concerned. Be sure to remark. Deflected by hitting the top of the tape on his way through.
Ackerman's return of serve has been incredible so far. The amount of net cord has actually produced off the return. I think Ackerman very wary of that. He's just left that one short.
Exactly, Mo's follow through from the racket. Look at this. Flick, that's it. Flat over on it, deep into the back corner. Great technique.
It's better to see those iron legs coming in being aggressive above the net board.
That's a wonderful shot, isn't it? Defensive play. It's just extraordinary.
Couldn't agree more. When I was playing against Liliana Natsir, it's almost folly to smash at her. You know it's coming back and it's coming back with interest. You're better off going for the stop drop in front of her or angle it towards the man. And the variation makes a big difference.
See, that's where the gap was. Out across court. And it was going in a downward direction.
He didn't try to over-hit the shot either. They didn't try to hit it too hard, which meant that he could get it that bit steeper.
Yurishnatu. Good return. I have to say the serve wasn't the best from Gunnar. And the 2 points are running out from the second consecutive title. serve.
Service open. 14-19.
Was indeed changed. Deficit. Just 3 points in it. Well, definitely understand the theory behind that. Jalian Lei wanted to block the shuttle foot, follow forward to the net. But she made the error, and it now means that the defending champions four match point opportunities to retain their title. First one well saved by Jalian Lei. 21-17, and they have defeated the reigning world and Olympic champions. Well, they simply didn't allow the Olympic champions to play their normal game, and that's all credit to the Indonesians.
Match won by Tontowi Ahmad.
Very, very focused throughout the Indonesians. Played better in today's final than I think they've played all week. And that's what you should be doing in any competition. Do enough to get through round after round and save your best and last. Absolutely tremendous performance by Tantowi Ahmad and Lilian Natsir. 21-13, 21-17 in 42 minutes.
Our mixed doubles champions, Liliana, you speak a little bit of English. You've retained your title. You obviously like playing here.
Today, we feel very happy. We play very good.
Thanks God and thanks family and thanks all.
And what would you like to say to your supporters?
Yeah, thank you for all support from Indonesia, for all support from my family in Indonesia and all my friends. Thank you so much.
Let's hear it for our mixed doubles champions, Dr. Tommy Ahmed, Liliana Natsir!
This is the final rally. The pressure, as had been the case so many times in that mixed doubles final, directed down at Zhao Yunlei. Retaining her title that they won last year. 33 years in waiting. 12 months ago for an Indonesian pair to win the All England mixed doubles. And it's a bit like the London buses. Two in quick succession.
So to make the presentations for the mixed doubles final here at the Yonex All England Open Badminton Championships, please welcome Paul Jensen, Managing Director of Yonex UK, and Jeff Roth, who's the President of Badminton England. And before we celebrate with our athletes, let's mark the contribution of the officials, our umpire from India, Girish Natu, and service judge, Andrea Ciappini of Italy, receiving their commemorative medals from Jeff Rose. Ladies and gentlemen, the runners up in the mixed doubles from China, Zhannan and Zhao Yunlei.
Less than a year ago, Zhao Yunlei could do no wrong. Two gold medals at the London Olympics today at the All England finals day has to settle for two runners-up places. Second Premier Super Series title from the Premier League.
And Paul will also present the winners with their OSIM Eurolax. And finally, receiving the trophies. The Yonex All England Open Mixed Doubles Champions from Indonesia, Tatiana Liliana Natsir! winners of the finals. We hope you enjoyed your experience here at the Yonex All England Open Badminton Championships. A huge thank you to our sponsors, our suppliers, and our volunteers. Without your partnership, simply wouldn't happen. We look forward to seeing you again in October for the Grand Prix event at the Copper Box on the Olympic Park.
Congratulations.
Obvious delight for the Indonesians retaining their title. As you can see, three titles going to China though, and it all started with women's doubles because Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang won their second title to the add to the one they won 2 years ago. Then a surprise in the men's doubles, Liu Xiaolong and Chu Xihan unseeded before they came to the tournament, but they've left as champions. Well, what a fairy tale for Tina Bon, because she's played her last tournament. She's won her last tournament, her third All England title. Li Chongwei was not at his best today, but all credit to Chen Long, who quite simply was superb. And as we saw in the mixed doubles, Tantoi Ahmad and Liliana Natsir retaining their title, the only players to retain their title in 2013. So it has been a wonderful week here in Birmingham. Tina Bout, for me, was the outstanding athlete. What a way to finish a career. And what a way for us to reflect on such a wonderful week here in Birmingham. There was upsets, there was drama, and there was the fairy tale ending for Tina Bout. for all of us in Birmingham. Until the next time, from Anthony Clark and myself, Jill Clark, bye-bye.